news channel, because we also have the Salem podcast. So that's why I am at Salem Podcast Network, Salem News Channel. Salem's getting very big, which is a good thing. Anyway, you can watch us, and I want to welcome Roxanne Beckford Hoge. She's an actress. Are you still acting, by the way?
I just got dropped my representation yesterday, in fact. But I've been a member of the union for 30 years, so sometimes yes. Sometimes
you were in some big movies, right?
Yeah, Bewitched and Father of the Bride and Something's Gotta Give. But tiny minutes in big movies, mostly sitcoms is what I've done.
Oh, is that what you did?
Mm-hmm.
Are you funny?
I have moments.
Because there were fewer funny women than funny men, I think.
It's not encouraged. A lot of women really want to look pretty, and I understand that. Like, I have that tension of, but I want to not look like an idiot, but I'm okay looking like an idiot.
Oh, that's an interesting point. That's right. Because Lucille Ball was a good-looking woman.
Yeah.
But that's not what people thought of. They just thought she's funny.
Yeah, and there's a moment in your development when you're like, but, and then you realize there's nothing better than laughter. And you let it go.
That is so interesting. I never thought of that. The tension in a woman about being known as a comedian. Anyway, the reason that Roxanne is with me today is she has a wonderful story about her evolution politically. Did your representation stop now because of your political views?
I'm not going to say that. It's probably more likely that I can't really work because the Screen Actors Guild has decided to zig while everyone else is zagging and require vaccines and boosters, and I don't participate in that.
Wait
so
a minute.
It's very hard for me to get work.
What does that have to do with SAG?
While everyone else is dropping mandates, they've gone the other direction and they're mandating boosters. So even though they test everyone, none of it makes sense, of course, but you have to attest at the beginning of an audition, even though there's dubious legality to asking someone these questions in a job interview, which is what an audition is, that you have had the vaccine and the booster. And I find that to be wrong.
Wow. You know, overnight, it has not become the subject of people's thinking because the masks are down. Masks say COVID, no masks say no COVID. But it is in Hollywood, meaning generically the world of movies and TV, you can't get a job without being vaccinated and boosted?
There's zones. I mean, it's insane how exclusionary and inequitable Hollywood is. So it's always been hierarchical, right? There were the above the line people and below the line people, but now there's literally zones of cleanliness, zone A, where you have to be vaccinated or boosted, but everyone is tested. I was tested 27 times last summer in order to be on hold to play Kamala Harris.
But wait, you played Kamala Harris?
They never did. They had me on hold. Clearly someone in a comedy staff wanted to make fun of her, and then they would put me on hold, and then they never actually pulled the trigger.
So I still want to understand. You can't work in Hollywood now if you're not vaccinated?
If you're worth it to them, in other words, someone with more brings more money to the table and eyeballs than someone like me, who's just a journeyman actor, yes. They'll test everyone on a set, just like how they dropped the vax mandate for the Oscars and the SAG Awards for performers. There's a lot of people who don't. There are people who have fake vax cards, but I'm not participating in any of it. And it just becomes another difficult thing for production. Well, we've got this person who can walk and talk and not bump into furniture, and then this person who says they have a religious or medical exemption, maybe we can't insure them. Forget it.
Is there any assumption this will end in the near future?
No. I mean, even mothers who I've been, you know, a part of for 25 years now as a parent, we know that the what they've said about dropping mask mandates at schools, it's all being held in reserve. It's all coming back. I mean, Fauci just said the other day, you know, we may need to. They're not letting go of any of this.
All right, when we come back, I want to hear, I'm as interested as the listeners will be, of your own political evolution, why it started, and what you do for PragerU. My guest is Roxanne Beckford Hoge, actress, and she's appeared at PragerU Stories of Us. I'll explain that to you. It's another terrific thing that we have up at PragerU. In the meantime, I want to relieve you of physical pain. I can't fully relieve you of anxiety pain given the world situation, but I can really help you with joint and muscle pain relief factor, which I have taken. Everybody I know has. I took it today because I worked out on Sunday, and I work out again today. Can't say I'm looking forward. I have a trainer. It's truly mind over matter doing such things. And anyway, I have the aches afterwards. I take the relief factor, and they're basically gone. I think of it as a miracle. Try it for 3 weeks. Why 3 weeks? Because they say you'll know in 3 weeks if it works. If it doesn't work, they tell you to cancel your order. How's that for honesty? For 20 buckaroos. $19.95 plus shipping. Try it, please. ReliefFactor.com,
800-500-8384.
Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Return some break in 2 minutes and 45 seconds. The Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Returns from break in 2 minutes and 15 seconds. Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Returns from break in 1 minute and 45 seconds. The Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Return some break in 1 minute and 15 seconds. Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Return some break in 45 seconds. Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Returns to break in 15 seconds. The Dennis Prager Show returns in 5 seconds.
I'm on the other side with the baby blues birds fly. Gray clouds, a white walls, a blue skies. We gon' fly, feel alright. Somebody help me feel alright tonight. Now we gon'
There's a novel idea. Support an educational institution that actually teaches your values. Prager University. Go to PragerUniversity.com and donate today. By the way, I want to say to Paul in Los Angeles, I do want to take your call. Paul wants to know how I could be on the right with white supremacists and anti-Semites. I can't tell you how much I want to take that call. That's why I'm even mentioning it. But I do have a guest. That's precious. I would love to hear Paul's thoughts on that.
Me too.
Yes, it's fascinating. Well, all these terrible people, Larry Elder and Ben Shapiro and Victor Davis Hanson and the writers on the Wall Street Journal editorial page, all these terrible people on the right that I'm associated with, it's an astonishing thing, but that's what keeps people voting left. The brainwash that people on the right are anti-Semites and white supremacists.
It's good marketing, but the most bigoted things I've heard in the past 15 years have all come from avowed progressives.
Well, you live among them. This is Roxanne Beckford Hoge, her married name. She's an actress, and she has been for how many years?
30
years. And so I'm very curious about your political evolution. So in a nutshell, what happened?
Well, you're the godfather, sort of the genesis. So when I became a mother, I spent an inordinate amount of time driving my children to sleep because I never had a good napper. So I would, you know, stick them in the car seat and drive. And popular music gets boring after a while. So I turned to talk radio. And I started listening to you. And I called you the first time. I was a dyed-in-the-wool liberal. My first call to you was about the death penalty. And I remember saying that you shouldn't have it because this guy had been a racist. He had done something horrible, a crime. It was a white person against a black person. I said he should be sentenced to life in prison with only black guards, black doctors, and black food providers, which was my logic at the time. Mm-hmm. And I think there were several other things I disagreed with you once. I even once wrote an article, and in one of the drafts it said, right-winger Dennis Prager thinks, whatever. And then two things happened. 9/11, and I sent my firstborn to public school. And I realized that the bumper sticker about the military needing the bake sale and public school having all the money they want, it wasn't a money issue. It was a will and expectations and cultural issue. I come from Jamaica. It's a poor third world. We're moving up to the second world, but it's not by anyone's imagination, a rich country. My school had, a roof and two walls for the assembly, but we had expectations of behavior, of academic excellence. And those expectations were for everybody on the island. So when people come to America from Jamaica, they excel, much like black immigrants from Africa itself,
Nigeria,
from Brazil, from Afro-Caribbean, the Latin countries. I mean, we see the same thing time and time again. So I realized that when you expect little, you get little, and that's what was happening in public school. And then I started to poke around and to evolve and grow. And you really helped that.
Good, I'm glad, that's why I'm here. So what's your connection to PragerU?
You had Barry Weiss on when she wrote her amazing article last summer, The Miseducation of the Elites. And you and she were talking about parents at these schools, at private schools, being cowards. And I called to disagree with you. And that led to my doing a PragerU. Marissa got in touch with me through another friend or something, and then we ended up doing that. And then coming full circle, Barry Weiss's sister interviewed me for an article on angry COVID moms who are running for office. And then, so now here we are.
So what exactly did you do for PragerU? You did a...
I did a Stories of Us, which is your great sort of subset of stories. And I think one of the best things PragerU does, and my little goal as an activist, I guess if you want to call it, in Los Angeles, is to let people know they're not alone. Because that is... What we're living under is the biggest gaslighting, emperor has no clothes event ever here in a really one-party state. And so when people can see, oh, wait a second, here's this person saying these things that I thought. I mean, I think the greatest weapon the left has against us is how good we are. Americans are so good. Angelenos are so good. No one wants to be called racist, and they'll do anything, including sacrificing their own children, in order to say, I'm not.
That's right, they do sacrifice their children.
Tell me about
your children and their school.
I have four kids who all went to, two are on their way out, because they're almost graduating. They're private religious K-12 school, and it has been our home and our community for 20 years. Mm-hmm. And I've been the we call it the den mother of the closeted conservatives of the school. And I have these little bird gatherings.
So it's a Christian school and there are closeted conservatives?
Absolutely.
You would think they would be closeted leftists at a Christian school.
Common sense is literally people can't say things that makes sense. They can't.
Tell my listeners what you had to sign, what agreement you had to sign.
So after Barry's article came out, and this happened, I actually had a meeting, and so there were parents at my house from a bunch of schools, and all of them pointed out that there has now been a change in the parental contracts. You have a contract for private school, and all of a sudden it became very clear that every parent was having to sign to say, I will not speak ill or cause any bad publicity to come to the school because of anything we teach, or we will not be invited back.
Did you hear that, folks? Anyway, this is what PragerU is in business to fight. Please help us. It's fundraising month. PragerU.com will continue.
Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Between some break in 2 minutes and 45 seconds. The Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Returns from break in 2 minutes and 15 seconds. Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Returns to break in 1 minute and 45 seconds. The Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Returns from break in 1 minute and 15 seconds. Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Return some break in 45 seconds. Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network returns to break in 15 seconds. The Dennis Prager Show returns in 5 seconds.
Was there really an exodus? Why did God save the Jews of Egypt, but not the millions of Jews that died in Europe? My new book answers these and many other questions. It's called The Rational Passover Haggadah. Relies on reason, just as my Rational Bible series does. So it's as relevant to non-Jews as to Jews, to atheists as to religious people. The Rational Passover Haggadah, available now at thepragerstore.com and wherever books are sold. Speaking to actress Roxanne Beckford, now Roxanne Beckford Hoge for a while though, right? You're Hoge for a while.
Yes, we've been married 25 years, but okay. I didn't take his name right away.
I understand. And she has a wonderful evolution from left to right. I've been part of that evolution. I didn't know, and I'm very, very honored to know that. She's made a wonderful video for PragerU in a series which you should all know about called Stories of Us, where people tell their own story, and it's very emotionally and intellectually riveting. So your kids are at a Christian school. You had to sign a parental agreement that you would never say anything bad about the school?
Well, look, everyone does privacy differently. Like, I don't put stuff on Facebook with pictures of my kids. I try not to. I try to keep that private. I love our school. And most of the people whose kids are in private schools in LA love their schools, because in a city, in a county this big, that's your community, you know? And so it's very disheartening to discover over the past 15 years that viewpoint diversity is not only not celebrated, it is so discouraged. And I mean, the administrators are between a rock and a hard place. I don't know if you've seen the undercover mothers who, after Barry's article, a group, again, all anonymous, who delved deeply into this to see, where is this coming from? Because there were, independent schools are independent, right? They all have their own philosophies and their own growth and their own paths and mission statements. But it turns out that the NAIS, the National Association of Independent Schools, which accredits private schools, is the top-down sort of forcing of these changes and taking away of independent
thought.
Because
the left has taken over every major institution.
Yeah. And we let them.
Just another example. You what?
We let them by ceding ground, right?
Yes.
By saying, oh, well, we won't, you know, that's entertainment. That's culture. That's education. Well, that's everything.
All right. Well, you should watch your video, Stories of Us. You should watch all of them. People of every background give their own story. It's very powerful. Roxanne, it's a joy to be with you.
You're an inspiration, and now I just want people to be a little brave, and that's why I'm running for the Board of Supervisors, because I got to put my money where my mouth is.
That's right. God bless you.
Dennis Prager Show on the Salem Radio Network. Between some break in 6 minutes, 45 seconds.